Iowa Republican Congressman Steve King is under fire again for controversial comments, and now members of his own party are taking him to task. King, who has defended racist speech in the past, told the New York Times, quote, "White nationalist, white supremacist, Western civilization, how did that language become offensive?" Republican Congresswoman Liz Cheney fired back on Twitter. She said these comments are abhorrent and racist and should have no place in our national discourse. Let's listen to King, because he spoke moments ago on the House floor.
"Today, the New York Times is suggesting that I'm an advocate for white nationalism and white supremacy. I want to make one thing abundantly clear. I reject those labels and the evil ideology that they define. Further, I condemn anyone that supports this evil and bigoted ideology, which saw in its ultimate expression the systematic murder of 6 million innocent Jewish lives. It's true that, like the Founding Fathers, I am an advocate for Western civilization's values, and that I profoundly believe that America is the greatest tangible expression of these ideals the world has ever seen. Under any fair political definition, I am simply an American nationalist."
All right, Essie Cupp here with us now. She's the host of CNN's Essie Cupp Unfiltered, and also John Bresnahan. He's the Congressional Bureau Chief for Politico with us. So King, Essie, says now he's just an American nationalist. What do you think about this cleanup? What do you think about his original remarks? What do you think about the Republican backlash?
Well, it's not much of a cleanup. Unfortunately, the president of the United States gave him permission to use that word proudly. He said it in a rally not long ago. Trump said, "Call me a nationalist. It used to be a bad word, but I want you to use it." It's still a bad word. It still doesn't mean anything good. Steve King is a bigot. He's a homophobe. He's an anti-Semite. He's a racist. He's a cancer on the country. And if you're the Republican Party, you don't cure cancer with vitamins. You cure it with radiation by blasting it into obsoleteness. And what I've heard from Republicans has been vitamins. Kevin McCarthy echoed what Liz Cheney said, that there's no place in society or discourse for this kind of language. There's no place in Congress for it. Let's start with Congress. We can't get him out of society. We're not going to kill Steve King. We're not going to jail him for free speech or even for being a racist bigot. But we can start with Congress. So if you think that he's a cancer and a scourge on the country, then you should want him out of elected office. There's a mechanism for that, and Republicans should take it up immediately.
John, I mean, he was reelected. He was just reelected in November. So.
By a narrow margin, though.
By a narrow margin. But nonetheless, he had the support of enough people in his Iowa district to come back to Washington, D.C. When leadership seriously looking at anything here? Do they have any concerns? Are they considering options? And what options would they have?
Well, there's two things that could happen immediately. The Democrats are looking at a censure motion. They would take a resolution to the floor criticizing King, and then the House could vote on that. Tim Ryan, a Democrat from Ohio, is trying to put together the votes on that. Now, there's a second thing they could do. Now, next week, the House Judiciary Committee, and King serves on that, is going to pick its subcommittee chairman and ranking member, and he's senior enough, he should get a ranking member spot, which gives you some staff. And, they won't say whether or not they're going to bar him from any kind of position on a subcommittee. So they could take action that way. They also could primary him or support somebody else for a primary. It's a long way off, but we tried to talk to Tom Emmer. He's the chairman of the National Republican Congressional Committee. We asked him about that, and they're not commenting. They're saying, well, we don't get involved in primaries, but they could get behind another candidate. So there are other ways to, you could take some steps now, you could take some steps later, but I think King has a real problem here. He's going to have to do more than what he did today.
He has a real problem. Yeah. So you think that this could go somewhere?
I think we could see a censure motion. I think we could see that. I mean, in a Democratic-run House, they could censure him. There's clearly some Republicans who would vote with that also. I mean, Justin Amash from Michigan, we were talking to him. He said, if it's worded correctly, he would vote for it. We could see some Republicans vote for it. Maybe, a no-cost vote, if you're voting against racism, that's not a hard vote. So, or a racist statement. So I think there would be some members who would support King, but, we'll see what happens there. That could very definitely happen.
What do you think about that, Essie?
it shouldn't be a hard vote. Voting against racism should not be a hard vote. Voting against a accused child molest, a predator like Roy Moore should not have been a hard vote. And yet we've seen far too little courage out of this Republican Congress. Look, you know, to John's point, you might not be able to get Steve King out until he is primaried in 2020, perhaps by Randy Feenstra, who has indicated he might run. But every Republican should be forced to be on record saying that this person should step down. And that's not hard either. Every single one of them, including leadership, should come up and say, this person does not represent us. He should not represent our party. And we want nothing to do with him. Congress wants nothing to do with him. Again, that doesn't do anything automatically, but at least it has Republicans on the record that they do not support what Steve King has said. Let's not forget, this isn't new. Steve King has been saying this kind of stuff for a long time. Just last year, you know, 5 minutes ago, he was defending his association with an Austrian far-right organization with neo-Nazi ties, saying if they were in America, they would be Republicans. Is this a person the Republican Party is proud of? If not, Republicans need to say so.